She's Meredith Barrow.
And he's Michael Jennings.
And we're DSF College Advisors. Welcome to FAFSA Night. You just watched an informative video that guided you through the FAFSA and its many features. This video was made last year, and we wanted to make sure to update you on a couple of aspects that have changed for the 2013-2014 FAFSA.
When you pull up the new FAFSA, you may notice a slightly different look than the one that appeared in the video. Each year, the FAFSA changes in small ways, such as the background and the location of certain links on the page.
If you have any questions about the FAFSA, please ask a DSF expert in the room.
The FAFSA requires the current year's tax information for the parent and the student, but it will allow you to fill out the document with the 2011 tax information. If you use the 2011 information, you will have to go back to the FAFSA form and enter the 2012 tax information after you file.
It is also important that you add this information to your FAFSA through the IRS data retrieval tool, which will be available on the FAFSA site in late February. The IRS data retrieval tool allows parents and students to transfer tax information directly from the Internal Revenue Service database into the FAFSA. You will have to allow 2 to 3 weeks if you file electronically for your tax information to appear in the IRS database and 6 to 8 weeks if you file with a paper document. Failure to use this feature may complicate the financial aid process, especially if you are called for verification by the institution.
Colleges are required to verify the accuracy of the information you provide on the FAFSA. The best way to confirm your tax information is to use the IRS data retrieval tool. If you do not or cannot use the IRS data retrieval tool, you may have to request an IRS tax return transcript from the IRS in order to complete your financial aid file. Failure to complete the IRS data retrieval tool or acquire an IRS tax return transcript can create several issues, such as a student not receiving financial aid, which can lead to a student being dropped from their classes or not receiving the DSF scholarship.
If you have any questions, please contact your DSF Future Center advisor.
It is also important to pay attention to your college's priority financial aid deadline, which can be found in the acceptance documentation that is sent to you through snail mail, email, or in your student portal. You will even be able to find these dates on the school's website under either the admissions or financial aid tab. Every school has its own priority aid deadline, which is the day that the college or university has set to receive all financial aid documentation, such as the FAFSA, CSS profile, and all verification forms if they were requested of you.
FAFSAs and verification forms that arrive after the deadline may not be considered for certain funding because the school has given all their funding away. For example, if Colorado State University has a priority date of March 1st and a student has not completed her financial aid verification papers by that date, then she will not qualify for scholarships that are offered by the institution.
Applicants who complete all of their financial aid requirements before the priority deadline will be considered for all available sources of financial aid, such as scholarships and grants. Missing the deadline means that you may not receive all of the aid that you might have qualified for.
Please pay attention to all information you receive from your college. Failure to do so may result in you missing out on thousands of dollars to help you pay for school.
Once again, thank you for attending the DSF FAFSA Night, and if you have any questions, please ask one of your DSF representatives.
Thank you.